Yo, what's up guys, back again with me Mato. Today in this video I'll be showing you guys the process I made graphic streetwear shirt design like this. As usual, you will see the entire process from scratch. Basically, I'm gonna manipulate image and try to make a cool design using Adobe Photoshop, and hopefully guys, after watching this video, you can get some inspiration or idea into your own work. So without further ado, open up the Photoshop and let's get right to it. Come on. Alright, first of all, I'm gonna create new document and start with 3000 by 3000 pixel with absolutely resolution 300 and give a random name to it. Now I'm gonna drop all my images into my document. I've come with idea to combine a machine or engine to my composition design. I'll try to cut several machine images that I have and make it to fit with cool head image, and I think I have something cool idea to start with and really hope that's become epic design. By the way, I put the download links for all this image in description for those of you who want to get them, so let's go. Now I'm gonna make some adjustment to each images so that it becomes a good design composition. Usually I'm use a pen tool to get the perfect selection to the images and swap all the part that I don't want it. Now I'm gonna speed it up the process a little bit, so stay tuned. Hold up baby, I got CBD. Now we should kick back, pop in a DVD. Yeah. We should keep the peace before one of us blows up like TNT. Let's go. I guess I'm crazy too. Not right in my mind, but I play it cool. A lot of emotions I convey are cruel, and my toxic traits are like deja vu. Ooh, that's the way I do. I'm a hot mess. Face the truth. I don't mean everything I say to you, but I know that I got you going crazy too. Damn. Cruise on the high road. Dodging the potholes. Tied up and I'm blindfold. She got me going psycho. I walk on a tightrope. My feet getting ice cold. My head spinning like a cyclone. She got me going psycho. After all the images set and perfectly pop into the composition I want, now I'm gonna balancing and adjusting the whole base color so it's more better and unified. Usually I play a little bit with color balance, adjust the levels and give you a little color using gradient map, and play randomly with the slider to get consistent colors in each image. And I think this step is the most important part before we move any further. So let's go. It's everything that she wants in abundance. Knows how to be a lady in public, but she can get crazy. Ooh, I love it. She got a lot of weight in her luggage. And shorty ain't bluffing. She might snap on you like it's nothing. Everything I thought I knew is redundant. Explosive temper. I hear smoke detectors. Alright guys, for make this composition being alive, now let's add the shadow over there. I'm just using a regular soft brush and smoothly spread my brush to the right area. You can follow my brush setup if you want it. Sometimes I play with opacity value and change the blend mode to the overlay if I feel too much while I adding this stuff. Now you can see the entire process, so let's go. CBD. Now we should kick back, pop in a DVD. Yeah. After I have added the shadows, now let's add a highlight to it so this design doesn't look too flat. In this process, I want to add a little orange color with the gradient map and smoothly spread my brush to the right area. This step exactly same way as adding a shadows, but if you're still confused or just wonder to know the way I make this part, I have made a tutorial of it. You can check it out this video in the pop-up on the top right corner. Now I'm gonna speed it up the entire process, so stay tuned. she a 100. Gets everything that she wants in abundance. Knows how to be a lady in public, but she can get crazy. Ooh, I love it. She got a lot of weight in her luggage. And shorty ain't bluffing. She might snap on you like it's nothing. Everything I thought I knew is redundant.
Alright guys, now it's time to the final touch up to make this design not too flat. Let's add some texture of it. I add my retro green pattern texture and add fire overlay to the surface of the skull head image. Actually, I add all this stuff just want to get extra detail so it will look more perfect when I see this design later. By the way guys, if you really want to have this texture, you can directly to comment below. I'll be pick it up for you and it's totally free for you guys. I hope this is gonna be helpful for you guys. Now I'm gonna speed it up the entire process, so stay tuned.
Hold up baby, I got CBD. Now we should kick back, pop in a DVD, yeah. Baby, we should keep the peace before one of us blows up like TNT. Let's go. I guess I'm crazy too. Not right in my mind, but I play it cool. A lot of emotions I convey.
Alright guys, now for optional touch up. Let's add the title to the design this time. Just to make a cool impression. For this title, I want to give a little touch of metallic effect to match with the overall design. I also adjust the position of it to make it more unified to the whole design. By the way, let me know by leave a comment below if you want to deep dive know about my technique while I create this stuff. And I will make a tutorial video about making this metallic text effect like that. Alright guys, after doing so many things happen to my work, and finally I got the perfect adjustment to the design, and honestly the result is so amazing. I'm so happy with it. I feel like I want to quickly print this design into a shirt and drive around a town in it. So let's put it into black shirt mockup to see the final result before I go to print it. Let's go.
Psycho, I walk on a tightrope. My feet get nice cold. My head spinning like a cyclone. You got me going psycho.
Alright guys, so that it's all for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. I'll be uploading another video later this week, so make sure you subscribe so you don't want to miss out. Follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes. Thanks for watching my video. See you on the next one. Peace.